So we're going to have a look at an algorithm for sorting a list, okay? And up the top here, we have a list. And as you can see, the numbers are not in a sorted order. They're kind of in a random order. So we've just got a print statement that prints that out. So to do this, first of all, we've got a variable down here which returns the length of the list. Okay, so the length of the list, how many items have we got in it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 items. Okay, and that's saved into list length. Okay, we've got swapped is equal to true. Okay, so that's a variable that controls the loop. And we've got the actual loop here. So while swapped is equal to true. So in other words, this loop will run assuming swapped is true. Okay, so we move into the loop down here and we've got swapped equals false. Okay, now this is used after the loop underneath here. We've got a for loop in here. This is used after this has finished. Okay, so in other words, once the list has been sorted, swapped will change to false and the main while loop will end. Okay, so we've got our for loop here. So for x in range 1, we're going to start at 1, to list length minus 1. Okay, the reason we've got minus 1 is if we're comparing two numbers, we've got the last number here and there's no other number to compare it to, so hence why the loop will end here. Okay, so we drop into the loop here and the first statement is this slightly complex looking statement here. But if we kind of sort of deconstruct it a little bit, we can figure out what's going on. So the x here is going to be 1 to start with. Okay, the reason being that here we've set the loop to start 1 rather than 0. Okay, so the first iteration of x is going to be 1. So it's always advisable just to label the pseudocode up if you're being asked to explain it. So I'm just going to put a little 1 above any time I can see x, because that's kind of what it means. Okay, so the first line just here, we're saying whatever's at position 1 in the list, the first item, which in this case is 6, okay, because remember positions start at 0 in lists, minus 1. Okay, so it's actually looking at 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the actual number it's looking at in a different colour, so we can kind of see what's going on here. Okay, so we've got 4, and then we're saying is 4 greater than numList x? Okay, so whatever's in the first position of the list. So if we look up here in the first position, we've got 6. So I'm just going to write that in, 6. So is 4 greater than 6? Okay, no, it's not. So none of this stuff here happens. Okay, so the loop then iterates back up here and x now becomes 2. Okay, so I'm just going to scribble very badly over the top of these ones to make them 2s. Okay. I think that's all of them. And we just get rid of 4 and 6. Okay, so let's have a look now then. So we're at now, x is now 2, okay, and I've just put 2s above here. So x position 2, so that is 0, 1, 2, so that's 2 we're looking at. But in this case, it's now minus 1, okay, so it refers to 6, okay. So again, in red, I'm just going to write 6 over here so we know what number we're dealing with. And we go across there and numList x2, so what's in position 2? 0, 1, 2, so 2 is in position 2. So I'm just going to write the number 2 in red. Okay, so now we're doing a comparison here. Is 6 greater than 2? Okay, yes it is. So in this case, we're going to run this part of the program. Now, what does this do? So down here, we've declared a new variable called temp, which stands for temporary. And we're saying whatever is at numList 2 minus 1, okay, which in this case is 6, needs to go into temp. So I'm just going to write over the top of temp 6 so we know what's inside it. Okay, the reason this happens is because when we swap numbers over later, we don't want to lose this number, so we have to hold it in a temporary variable. Think of it as a bit like a little box that we can put it in to save it for later. So now this is where the swap happens, okay, just here. So we've got x minus 1, okay, which is second position in the list, 0, 1, 2, minus 1, which is 6. Okay, so I'm just going to write that over the top. So we know that's 6, and we know this is position 2 in the list, so 0, 1, 2, so we know that's 2. So we're going to write a 2 over the top of it. Okay, so what's actually happening here is 2 is going to where position 6 was. Okay, so up here, 2 is being moved to this position and 6 is now gone. Okay, but as we know, 6 is not gone, it's in our temporary variable, so we've got it held. So what happens now is this line of code runs, and what we're saying is whatever is a temp, okay, which we know is 6, now assign that number to numlist x. And numlist x is 2 at the moment, so assign that to position 2 on the list. So let's find position 2, 0, 1, 2. So the 6 now goes where the 2 was. So let's just add that in. Okay, so that's now 6 and that's now 2. So we can see those two numbers have swapped over. Okay, and the final bit is this line here, swapped equals true. So the loop still carries on, okay, up here and goes back down here, and now x becomes 3, okay, and then the whole process happens again. So it's a bit of a complicated piece of code, a bit of a complicated algorithm, but that's essentially how it works. It gets the number in the list, compares them. If the number's greater than the other, it puts it into a temporary variable, which it saves for later, copies the other number into the position that it was, that the greater number was, and then puts the greater number in the position that the previous number was. Okay, so that's essentially how the sorting algorithm works.